पठामि संस्कृतं नित्यम्।
संस्कृतं नित्यम्।
वदामि
पठामि
संस्कृतं
संस्कृतं
सदा।
नित्यम्। वदामि संस्कृतं सदा।
ध्यायामि संस्कृतं सम्यक्।
ध्यायामि संस्कृतं सम्यक्।
वन्दे संस्कृतमातरम्।
वन्दे
वन्दे
संस्कृतमातरम्।
संस्कृतस्य प्रसाराय।
संस्कृतस्य प्रसाराय।
नैजं सर्वं ददाम्यहम्।
नैजं सर्वं ददाम्यहम्।
संस्कृतस्य सदा भक्तो।
संस्कृतस्य सदा भक्तो।
वन्दे संस्कृतमातरम्। वन्दे
वन्दे
संस्कृतमातरम्।
संस्कृतमातरम्।
संस्कृतस्य कृते जीवन्।
संस्कृतस्य
संस्कृतस्य
कृते
कृते
जीवन्।
जीवन्। संस्कृतस्य कृते यजन्।
संस्कृतस्य कृते यजन्।
संस्कृतस्य कृते यजन्। आत्मानमाहुतं मन्ये।
आत्मानमाहुतं मन्ये।
वन्दे संस्कृतमातरम्।
वन्दे
वन्दे
संस्कृतमातरम्।
संस्कृतमातरम्। वन्दे संस्कृतमातरम्।
वन्दे
वन्दे
संस्कृतमातरम्।
संस्कृतमातरम्। अस्तु, इदानीं वयं प्रवेशपुस्तके पञ्चम अध्यायं पठन्तः सन्ति। अत्र सूक्तिः अस्ति, क्रियासिद्धिः सत्त्वे भवति महतां नोपकरणे इति। महतां क्रियासिद्धिः सत्त्वे भवति उपकरणे न इति। सत्त्वे इत्युक्ते अस्माकं सात्विकगुणाः भवन्ति खलु, सात्विकगुणाः, अन्तः एतत् कर्तुं शक्नुमः, तत् कर्तुं शक्नुमः, एतादृश एक उत्तमगुणाः भवन्ति। तादृशगुणाः सत्त्वगुणं रचयति। इट कुड बी लूजली क्लासिफाइड एज द पॉजिटिविटी, द इंटरनल एबिलिटी, द जेन्युइन इंटेंशन विथ विच वी वॉन्ट टू डू इट लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स। सो अ लॉट ऑफ सच क्वालिटीज टुगेदर ब्रिंग द इंटरनल स्ट्रेंथ। अतः सत्वे भवति। सो व्हाट दिस इज, महतां क्रियासिद्धिः, द ग्रेट अचीवमेंट्स और वॉट एवर एक्शन वी टेक, हाउ एवर बिग इट माइट बी, they get completed because of our sattva thinking or sattvika inherent abilities. Upakarane nasti, not because of the instruments that we use. So even if we do not have the right instruments, those are not really excuses, because those are just helping us to achieve it. But our sattva thinking and ability and intention is what is going to help us achieve, however great the action we take us. सो महतां क्रियासिद्धिः सत्त्वे भवति उपकरणे न इति सूक्तिः। इन्फैक्ट् व्हेन आई वाज टेलिंग दिस, आई एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट द एग्जांपल ऑफ सूर्य भगवान, वेयर सूर्य भगवान इज द एग्जांपल टिपिकली व्हेन पीपल यूज द सूक्ति, बिकॉज दिस इज पार्ट ऑफ दैट सुभाषितम विच सेज दैट। नाउ थिंक अबाउट सूर्य भगवान, ही हैज अ चैरियट विथ 7 horses, and each of it is tied with a serpent instead of a thread, and he has to handle 7 serpents simultaneously in order to ride his chariot. He has his Aruna as his charioteer, and who has a leg challenged, you know, he is not a completed child when he was born, so he is a challenged child who is a charioteer. So Aruna Sarathi, Aruna is a sarathi, and he is you know, got to travel huge distances every morning and evening at the same time. And his chariot has only one wheel. Eka Chakran is what we call sun god. Now, with all these things, he is so punctual every single day, coming in and, you know, setting exactly to help all of us. So his intention is to give life to, you know, the world. So because his intention is sattve bhavati, mahatam kriya siddhihi saha karoti. Atah suryam samsmara nityam is the way the beautiful Subhashitam goes. And there is one of this director by name Hegde Mahodaya, who composed a beautiful song which was released in Samskrita Bharati with this as the main phrase, Kriya Siddhihi Sattve Bhavati Mahatam Nopakarani. So that was the main phrase. He created this song. And so I said in one of the future classes, I will teach that song. So I have that song here. We will start with that today. It's a very, very inspiring song. At the right point in our lessons, I'll even go through the meaning. It has a lot of subtle meanings, but we have to learn a little bit of grammar to enjoy that a little more. So we'll do that. Kriya Siddhihi Sattve Bhavati. One of you can follow me. Maybe Sudha Bhagini can follow me. Kriya Siddhihi Sattve Bhavati.
Kriya Siddhihi Sattve Bhavati.
Mahatam Nopakarane.
Mahatam Nopakarane.
Kriya Siddhihi Sattve Bhavati.
Kriya Siddhihi Sattve ve bhavati
mahatam nopakarane
mahatam nopakarane
seva
dikshita
chira
pratigya ma vismaravo
suktim
suktim
Ma vismara bho suktim. Sujata Mundra. Kriya Siddhihi Sattve Bhavati.
Kriya Siddhihi Sattve Bhavati.
Mahatam Nopakarane.
Mahata Nopakarane.
Seva dikshita chira pratignya
ma vismar bho suktim
Anu Bhagini. Nadhanam nabalam. Napi sampada. Nadhanam nabalam. I'm just repeating that. Nadhanam nabalam.
Okay. Nadhanam nadbalam.
Napi sampada.
Nasya jananukampa. Your voice is not clear, Praveena Guru.
Oh.
Okay. Can I repeat? After you.
Praveena Guru, what is the meaning of Nasya Jnananukampa?
I'll explain the whole sloka, don't you worry.
Okay.
Nadhanam nabalam. Napi sampada.
Napi sampada.
Nasya jananukampa.
Siddhanasya.
Bhumika.
कार्य भूमिका
न्यस्यादपि प्रोत्साहः
न्यस्यादपि प्रोत्साहः आवृणोतु वा
विद्ववारिधिं
विघ्नवारिधिं
त्वं मा विस्मर सूक्तिं
सत्वं मा विस्मिर सूक्तिं
त्वं मा विस्मर सूक्तिं
दिस्
आशा भगिनी क्रिया सिद्धि सत्वे भवति
क्रिया सिद्धि सत्वे भवति
महतां नोपकरणे
महतां नोपकरणे
सेवादीक्षित चिर प्रतिज्ञा
कम अगेन प्रवीणा बिकॉज मम पास सेवादीक्षित
चिर प्रतिज्ञा
चिर प्रतिज्ञा
मा विस्मर भो
मा परबो
सूक्तिम
सूक्तिम
मा विस्मरबो सूक्तिम
मा विस्मरबो मरबो
सूक्तिम
सूक्तिम
सम्यक देयर आर फोर पैराग्राफ्स द रिमेनिंग टू पैराग्राफ्स वी विल डू इट टुमारो सो we will go through the details a little bit later but the main part is kriya siddhihi satve bhavati mahatam nopakarane mavismarabo suktim so this sukti please do not forget so that is the essence which is you know told in all the four paragraphs so the specific meaning the specific words we will go into detail I just want to finish a little bit of grammar so that we will be able to appreciate this a little better okay so we will continue okay so we had already learnt about the prathama vibhakti of the nouns so ramah ramau ramaah balakah balakau balakaah so whenever we spoke about saha kah saha ramah saha kah सह बालकः ते के ते बालकाः करेक्ट सो वी स्पोक अबाउट द सिंगुलर ड्यूअल एंड प्लूरल फॉर्म्स ऑफ अकारांतः आकारांतः इकारांतः एंड आल्सो अबाउट द नपुंसकलिंगम अकारांतः लाइक द फलम पुष्पम एक्सेट्रा फलम फले फलानि पुष्पम पुष्पे पुष्पानि एंड इफ यू कम टू स्त्रीलिंगम सीता शब्दः बालिका शब्दः बालिका बालिके बालिकाः नदी नद्यौ नद्यः देवी देव्यौ देव्यः सो ऑल दीज आर एक्चुअली द वेरी फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ द डिक्लेंशन दैट वी विल बी लर्निंग व्हेन वी स्पीक ऑफ द फर्स्ट लाइन इट मींस द प्रथमा विभक्ति सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रथमा विभक्ति और द वेरी फर्स्ट लाइन of the 8x3 matrix of the noun forms which we'll be learning okay so till now whatever we've learnt in the first four chapters was primarily utilizing the first line saha kaha te ke tani kani all these whenever your question was what typically the answer will belong to the prathama vibhakti so that is what we've learnt so here if you notice The Pratipatikam is Rama. Rama is the root form. We learned that in one of the classes earlier. The root form of the noun is called as the Pratipatikam. And that root form takes several different forms in the declension. Now Rama in the Prathama Vibhakti becomes Ramaha. So whenever a word Ramaha is used, you will immediately know it is Prathama Purushaha Ekavachana Rupam. So when you see the word Ramaha, what would it mean? It would mean Ramaha is Bhaguvachanam Pratama Purushaha. And you will also know it is Akarantaha Pullingaha. Rama is the Pratipadikam, so Rama Shabdaha is what you will say. Okay. So now let's just take the same example. Suppose I say Balakau. What would it mean?
Balakau.
Yeah. Yeah,
right? Dvivachanam.
Dvivachanam.
Tell me the whole sentence. I wanted something like what I told for Ramaha. It would be Akarantaha Pullingaha Rama Shabdaha Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachana Rupam. That is what is Ramaha. So when I say Ramau, what will happen?
Akaranta Pumlingaha Pratama Vibhakti Dvivachanam.
And Rama is the Pratipadikam. So you should say Rama because many understand is Ramaha, which is not correct. Rama is the root form. Ramaha is its first derivative. So we should understand it that way. Now let me say Balakaha. What would that mean? Balakaha.
Akaranta Pulingaha Prathama Vibhakti Bahuvachanam Shabda.
Balaka Shabdaha.
Balaka
Shabdaha Bahuvachanam.
Okay.
Prathama Vibhakti Bahuvachanam Uttam. So similarly, when we go to Sita, Sita now becomes similar, but it's just a Strilinga Shabda. And because the ending is Sita, it is not Akaranta, it is Akarantaha. Okay. So the way we will tell this is Akarantaha, Strilingaha, Sita Shabdaha, Sita, Sita, Sitaha, Sita, Sita, Sitaha. So if I say Sita, what would the sentence be, Anu Agarwal?
It will be Sita Shabdaha Akaranta Strilinga Pratham Vibhakti Dvi Vachane Sita.
Excellent. So you can tell that in this sequence, like what we've written here itself, Akarantaha Strilingaha Sita Shabdaha Pratama Vibhakti Dvivachana Rupam. So okay. That is how okay. We actually complete okay. The entire sentence.
Okay.
Lakshmi Bhagini, Sitaha.
Akaranta Sita Shabdaha.
Tell it in the sequence itself. Akarantaha.
Strilinga.
Akarantaha Strilinga Pradhama Vipatti Bahuvachana Rupaha.
So Akarantaha Strilingaha Sita Shabdaha. So usually the Pratipatikam we suffix it with the word Shabdaha so that it's very clear. Sita Shabdaha. Shabdaha means the declension of the 8x3 matrix. We are in the first line. That is what is Pratama Purushaha. So then you come to Sitaha, which would mean that it is the Bahuvachana Rupam. So that is how we usually tell this. Excellent. Because instead of knowing this, people usually by heart the table and they don't know why they are by hearting the table. So we have to understand what the table actually means to go further. Okay. Now, instead of Sita, if I substitute it with Balika, Shraddha Bhagini, what would Balika translate to? How would you explain that?
Akarant Striling Balika Shabdah Prathama Vibhakti Ekvachanam Rupam.
Ekvachanam Rupam. Uttamam. Uttamam. Now let's go to Ikarant Strilingah. So Devi Shabdah. Devi. Therefore it's not Ikarant, it is Ikarantah. Devi Shabdah. Devi Devyau Devyaha. Devi Devyau Devyaha. So you will say Ikarantaha Strilingaha Devi Shabdaha Devi Devyau Devyaha. Okay. So let us see. Suppose I say Nadyau Swaminathan Mahodaya. How will it translate to Nadyau?
Ikaranta Strilingaha Nadi Shabdaha
Pradama Vibhakti Dvivachanam.
Nadi, Nadyau, Nadyaha, Pratama Vibhakti, Dvivachana Rupam, Samyak. Nadyaha, Renu Bhagini.
Nadyaha. Ikaranta, Istri Lingaha, Nadi Shabdaha, Pratama Vibhakti, Bahuvachana Rupam.
Excellent. So everybody understands the essence of what we are doing here, right? So let us see. Now we are going to Napumsaka Lingam, which is neuter gender, Palam, Pale, Palani. Akarantaha, Napumsaka Lingaha, Pala Shabdaha. So if you notice all the Pratipatikam here, it is Rama, Sita, Devi, Pala. So end of this is what is the Antaha that we've mentioned here. So Rama, Im plus A, right? So the ending is A. Therefore, it becomes the antaha, akara antaha. Sita is it plus a. Therefore, antaha is a. Devi is dev, iv plus e. Therefore, ikara antaha. Pal plus a, akara antaha. So, all this antaha defines the template of how we want to decline the entire shabda. So, instead of Rama, if I say Krishna, that also ends with a. So your declension will be similar. Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha. Krishnaha, Krishnau, Krishnaha. So once you have one template in mind, you can just replicate similar shabdas by identifying the ending, by identifying the antaha. So that is how Sanskritam creates these templates. So you don't have to by heart every single thing. You can just go by how it ends. So akara antaha, napum sakalingaha, phala shabdaha. Palam, pale, palani. Suppose I say pushpam. Okay. Pushpam, pushpe, pushpani. So, pushpani, what would it be, Raji?
Akarantaha, napumsakalingaha. Pa, pushpa, pushpa, shabdaha. Prathama vibhakti, ekavachana rupam.
Pushpani?
Oh, Pushpani, sorry. Bahuvachana Rupam.
Bahuvachana Rupam. Uttama. Raj Mahodaya, Kanduke.
Kanduke. Akaranta Napun. Sorry.
Akaranta.
Raji was saying something?
No, I had forgotten to mute myself, Raj. You carry on.
Okay. Akaranta ka? Akaranta napunsakalinga. What was the word you gave me?
Kanduka ball.
Kanduka shabdaha prathama vibhakti bahu vachanam kandukani. Or you actually asked me dui vachanam kanduke.
Exactly.
You asked me dui vachanam, sorry.
Yes. Vivachana rupam kanduke. So this is how you identify it. So once you all are very clear with this first vibhakti, Prathama vibhakti, which we've been learning, it's just that we are giving you a structure now. We've been using these all the way. So you should know that Pratipatikam is the Moolam. Pratipatikam plus the vibhakti pratyaya of whatever we are adding now, Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, to make it the appropriate thing. We will get the different words which are used for the declension of the entire matrix. So let's go on to doing some exercise here. Devaha. Devaha. Raji?
Say the entire form, right?
Yes.
Akaranta pullingaha deva shabdaha pratipatikam. Devaha.
You can just say deva shabdaha. Shabdaha
deva
pratipatikam
shabda.
Is synonym.
Okay, deva shabdaha prathama vibhakti rama devaha devau devaha.
I will not say it is synonyms. Pratipatikam is actually the root word. Shabda is the declension.
Okay, got it. Moola shabdaha is pratipatikam. Shabdaha is the shabdam, word itself.
Moola padam is the pratipatikam. Rama in this case is the
pratipatikam. So akaranta pullingaha deva shabdaha deva. You asked me for deva shabdaha. Deva shabdaha. Prathama vibhakti. devaha devau devaha
prathama vibhakti excellent so let's do similar things gataha sudha bagini gataha
akarant napunsak linga
is it gataha gataha atah pullinga eva
akarant pullinga gata shabda prathama vibhakti gataha gathau gataha
ha uttam upan samudrah shraddha bagini
akarant napusakling
pullinga samudrah pullinga eva whenever you see the visarga it will invariably be pullinga eva
okay
because sanskritam goes by the shabda not by the meaning of the words right okay. so samudrah pullinga
akaran pulling shabda samudrah prathama vibhakti samudrah samudro samudrah
here what you have to remember is the shabdah here you will not say samudrah shabdah you will say samudra shabdah
samudra
the visarga will not be there pratikatikam does not include visarga okay it will only be a vowel which ends typically for the topics we are learning now in the future we'll also learn you know conjugations but now we'll learn whatever words end with these primary vowels
I just wanted to ask what do you mean by declension
Declension is now you see three different forms of Rama, right?
Yeah.
So you have 8 × 3, which is 24 different forms for every word. So that table is called as the declension table. The way we arrange from a word, how do you derive so many other words? So that derivation is called as a declension.
Thank you.
Shabdha.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. So. We've seen Ramah, Ramau, Ramah, Devah, Devau, Devah, Gatah, Samudrah, Vrikshah. Anu Agarwal Bhagini.
Akaranta Pullingah, Vriksh Shabda, Pratham Vibhakti, Vrikshah, Vrikshau, Vrikshah.
Excellent.
The connectivity is the problem.
Oh, it's not clear?
No, it was clear.
Okay. Snehitah. Renu Agarwal Bhagini. Snehitah.
Snehitah. Akaranta. Pullinga. Prathama vibhakti.
Snehita shabdah.
Snehita shabdah. Pullinga. Prathama vibhakti. Ekavachana.
No, no. Tell the three things. Snehitah.
Snehitah shabdah ekvachan rupam.
No, no. Tell all the three things. Snehitah, snehitau.
Acha, snehitah, snehitau, snehitah.
Ah, snehitah, snehitau, snehitah. So it will be snehita shabdah.
Snehita shabdah.
Okay. Now, let's go on. Deepah. Kavita Modi Bhagini, Deepah.
Akaranta prathama vibhakti pullingah
yeah just go in the sequence it'll be easier akarantah
okay. akarantah pullingah deepah shabdah
deepah or deepa shabdah that aha should not come when you saying
okay.
the shabda
okay, okay. okay akaranta pullingah दीप शब्दः प्रथम विभक्ति दीप दीपः दीपौ दीपाः
एक्सेप्ट दीपः दीपौ दीपाः ओके नाउ लेट अस मूव ऑन टू स्त्रीलिंगम ओके सो व्हाटएवर यू सी इन द सेकंड स्तंभ आर ऑल स्त्रीलिंगम भक्ता सो व्हाट विल बी द एंडिंग आकारांतः स्त्रीलिंगः लता आकारांतः स्त्रीलिंगः वर्तिका आकारांतः स्त्रीलिंगः गटी ikarantah strilingah. Can you identify it? Just by seeing the words, you should be able to say whether it is akaranta, akaranta, ikaranta, etc. Now, what would nadi be? Ikarantah. What would saki be?
Ikarantah.
So the second stamba, whatever you see, is ikarantah. So we will just take one example, and then the remaining you can do as part of your activities in your groups. Now let us say bhakta.
Shall I say?
Let's say bhakta. Sujata Mundra Bhagini, who wants to say?
Bhakta.
Sujata Mundra, go ahead.
Akaranta. Shabda. Bhakta. Pratham vibhakti. Bhakta. Bhakte. Bhaktaha.
Bhakta, bhakte, bhaktaha. Uttamam. Bhakta, bhakte, bhaktaha. Now let's take one more example. Latha. Let's take Latha.
Guru, can I try?
Yes, please go ahead.
Can I have the table? No, the other table. Huh? It's Akarantaha, Sri Langa. Lata, Pratama Vibhakti. What was the shabda I said? Lata, Late, Lataha.
I thought you were traveling and tried to be nice to you by not asking you questions.
No, but it's so clear, my connectivity.
Okay, good. then you. Are you going to sing that for me today?
Oh, I don't think I don't have that book with me. Sorry.
Okay, okay.
I only have my phone, Guru. Thank you.
Okay. Lata, Late, Lataha. Excellent. Okay. So let's take one ikarantaha now. Saki. Lakshmi Bhagini. Yes.
Okay. Ikaranta. Strilinga shabda. Ikaranta. Strilinga. Saki shabda. Pradhama vibhakti sakhi sakhau sakaha.
Sakhi sakyau sakyaha. See here, you have Devi. Devyau devyaha, right?
Yes, yes. Sakhi sakyau sakyaha.
Sakhi sakyau sakyaha. Nadi. Nadyau nadyaha.
Ikaranta is not there, Guru.
What?
Ikaranta, Srilinga is there. Ikaranta, Pumlinga is there?
That is very rare. Typically, most of the pullinga will be akaranta, majorly, at least for our Pravesha syllabus. And at this point, most of the strilinga will be ikaranta only. That's very, very...
So finding out the shabda, it'll be very easy then.
At this point, it will be easy only for us. Okay, going forward, fine. There's a lot of confusion in place.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
In fact, you will learn Hari, which is Ikaranta Pullingaha. We'll be learning that. Okay.
Kavi and Muni also. But...
Yeah, Kavi Muni. I'm not sure if it's there in Pravesha. I'll have to check. It's there in Pravesha? Okay.
Mama Samipe, Vatat Pustakam Nasti.
Oh, Astu. Okay, so let's go to Napumsakalingam. Now, Mandiram, Griham, Jalam, Pushpam, Mitram, Tailam, all these are Napumsakalingam. So let's just take Griham, for example. So let's do Griham. Who have I not asked today? Some are muted today. Raj, do you want to try Griham?
Sure. Akaranta Napumsakalingam. Griha shabdaha prathama vibhakti griham grihe grihani.
Griham grihe grihani. Excellent. Okay. Pushpam. Renu Bhagini.
Akaranta napunsaklinga prathama vibhakti Pushpa shabda, pushpam, pushpe, pushpani.
Okay. So this is how you actually conjugate. We've now done the first line of these four basic shabdas: akaranta, akaranta, ikaranta, and akaranta napumsakalinga. So try to create such statements with all these things, maybe in your group activity, so that you will get more comfortable using the different shabdas. So the correct way of telling this will be akarantaha. You can see antaha here. Akarantaha, pullingaha, rama shabdaha. Now, because we are learning, we are saying prathama vibhakti. Otherwise, you directly say the shabdas itself. Ramaha, ramau, ramaha. Okay, that's how you actually say. Akarantaha, strilingaha, sita shabdaha, sita, sita, sitaha. Ikarantaha, strilingaha, devi shabdaha, devi, devyau, devyaha. Akarantaha, napumsakalingaha, pala shabdaha, palam, phale, palani. Yes, Raj.
So this translates to one Rama, two Ramas, many Ramas.
Correct.
One Sita, two Sita, many Sitas. One Devi, two Devis, many Devis. Right?
Correct.
That's yes. How the usage comes down the road.
Yes. Yes. One fruit, two fruit, many fruits. So the moment you say Balakau, you know that there are two boys. You don't have to specifically say that Dvau Balakau. You know, it is assumed. It's explicit in that sense. Phale means two fruits. So, okay. Similarly, for pronouns, we've again been using these. Now it's in a good table form for us to understand it very clearly. Saha balakaha, te balakaha. We've learned that. Saha balakaha, tau balakau, te balakaha. We know this. So the pronoun form will be similarly, saha, tau, te. But now they are explaining that the pratipadikam of this is actually tat. Tat, with a lot of these algebraic equations, finally comes and ends up in a saha. Okay, so tat, it is the ending. Pullingaha, tat shabdaha, and the formation becomes saha tau te. So that is how you understand it. So it is the antaha. Similarly, kim, makarantaha pullingaha, kim shabdaha im, kaha kau ke is the form. So, saha kaha, tau kau te ke is how we use it. When it comes to srilingam, we all have learnt it, right? Sa balika, taha balikaha, so sa te taha. The questions will be ka ke kaha. And then for napunsakalingam, te tani tat palam, tani palani, tat pushpam, tani pushpani, we learnt all that. So tat te tani, the questions will be kim ke kani. So here they are giving you that, you know, for each of this pullinga rupam, strilinga rupam, and napumsakalinga rupam, the same shabda tat is used, but it takes the different forms. Okay? The same tat, when you are using it in the pullingam form, then it takes saha tau te, because it's a pronoun, sarvanama shabdaha. The same tat, when it takes the strilingam form, it becomes sa te taha, because the pratipadikam, the root is the same, but it gets added to the different forms, thereby getting different words for representing strilingam. Similarly, the same tat, for napumsakam becomes tatte tani. So this is what we have to remember, that the pratipadikam can take different shabda rupas. Okay. So that's what they've explained here. Saha balakaha, tau balakau, te balakaha, sa balika, te balika.
Alina, the previous balika. Slide, can you show 1 minute? Previous one. Yeah, thank you.
Saha balakaha, tau balakau, te balakaha. Sa balika, te balike, taha balikaha. Sa devi, te devyau, taha devyaha. Tat palam, te pale, tani palani. Clear, no? Okay. Now, let's learn the words for some writing instruments. Okay. So, lekana samagri, writing instruments. Okay. Can each of you read one of this? Especially for those who know Hindi very well, be very careful about the ardhamatra prayoga, because in Hindi we are so used to ending with half the matra. In Sanskritam you have to remember to say the word completely, so that is some challenge that we face in many people who are very conversant with Hindi. So we'll have to be very conscious because this is Sanskrit.
Lekhani. Varna lekhani.
Varna lekhani.
Atkani. Marjani.
Marjani is eraser. In fact, you can use it for even, you know, the dusters, anything that we use for cleaning, you can use marjani equivalent. And look at this. It's such an easy thing. Utpitika is table. Antapetika. So just the inner thing is called as a drawer. So antapetika. Now let's just take this. Petika. How would the Shabda Rupa be?
Akaranta.
There you go. Panditaha. Akaranta.
Akaranta Napunsakalingaha. Strilinga.
Strilinga.
Petika.
Akaranta. Strilinga. Petika. Shabda.
Petika. Petika. It's not Napunsakalinga.
Petika.
Akaranta Strilingaha. Shabdaha Petika. So Petika, Petike, Petikau.
Petikaha.
Petikaha.
Petika, Petike, Petikaha. Now let's see one more. Sudakandaha. What would the Shabda be?
Akaranta. Akaranta Purush Pumling.
Pullingaha.
Sudakanda Shabda.
Sudakanda Shabdaha.
Suddha Kandaha. Shabdaha Sudakanda. Prathama Vibhakti. Sudakandaha. Sudakandau Sudakandaha.
Uttamam. Sudakandaha, Sudakandau, Sudakandaha. Let's try something Sudha else. Lekani.
Kandaha.
Lekani.
Can I try?
Yeah, try.
Ikaranta, Srilinga, Lekhani, Lekhanau, Devi, Devyo, Devya, Lekhanya.
Lekhani, Lekhanyau, Lekhanyaha. Uttamam.
Lekhani, Lekhanyau, Lekhanya.
Try Ankani.
Can I try Ankani, Guru?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay. Ankani. Ikaranta Strilinga Ankani Shabdaha Ankani Ankanyo Ankanaha.
Ankanyaha.
Ankanyaha.
Devyau Devyaha, right?
Ankanyo Ankanyau Ankanyaha.
What is the Shabda? Shabda is
Ankani. Shabda is Ankani.
Shabda. Nadi
Shabda. Ankani Shabda. Ankani Shabda. Ankani. Ankanyau. Ankanya.
Marjani. Sujata Mundra.
Marjani.
Marjani. Ikaranta. Striling. Shabda Marjani.
Strilingaha. I'm not going to leave this. It's not Hindi. Strilingaha.
Strilingaha. Marjani. Shabda. Marjani, Marjanya, Marjanya.
Marjani, Marjanya, Marjanya. Actually, even the panditas who, you know, are so used to Hindi, when you see their lectures and all, it will be like a little bit of, you know, the ardhamatra pronunciation will be there. So while we start itself, we should be very clear to distinguish because we are using the same script. That is the challenge. Our mind automatically goes to the Hindi way of pronouncing. So we should be very conscious about it. Okay. So we have more of the Lekana Samagri here. Who wants to continue reading this? Yes, go ahead.
Patra Suchi, Damshakam, Lepana
Pantika, Pattika,
Pantika,
Lepana Pattika,
Lepana Pattika,
Elephant Tape, yeah.
Nittasaha,
Niryasaha,
Niryasaha,
Randrika. Randram means hole. Randrika, the puncher.
Randrika.
Okay, let's try Randrika. Who wants to try Randrika? Which shabda will it be?
I'll try.
Yes.
Akaraha. Srilinga. Randrika shabdaha. Randrika. Randrika.
Randrika. It'll be like Sita.
Kaha.
Sita, Sita, Sita. Ha. Randrika, Randrike, Randrika. Ha.
Randrika. Oh, I said Randrikau. That's wrong, isn't it?
Randrike.
Randrika.
Randrika, Randrike, Randrika. Ha. Sita, Randrike, Sita. Ha.
Randrika. Ha. Oh. Dhanyavaad.
What more do we have? Lekana Phalakam. Patra Bharaha. How simple they coin these words. That's the beauty of Sanskritam. You can attach two words to form your own new words. So Bharaha, we know, is weight. Patram, you know, is paper. Now, what do you call for paper weight? Patra Bharaha. So you just coin new terms very, very easily here. Kattari, we know. Mapika. Mapika, what will be the shabda? Mapika.
Istrilinga.
Istrilinga.
Akaranta. Mapika, mapike, mapika.
Wonderful.
Mapika shabda.
Akaranta, Istrilinga, mapika shabda. Mapika, mapike.
Well done, Redo.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, so I'm going to just finish with this today. You all can, usually, you know, the traditional Gurukula pattern, what people used to do is they used to take one paragraph. So for every word, they will stop. After every word, they will find out what is the Pratipatika, and they will go on to declining the 8x3 matrix completely along with the source. Then go on to the next word. That is the way they used to learn in traditional schools. So by the time they finish one paragraph, they will be perfect about every single word, the different forms of what is there. And, you know, they'll have a complete knowledge. That's how the learning was traditionally done. So here we just did a sampling, you know, taking some words and enjoying the derivation part of it. But you can take some stories in our Pravesha book and then do this process of how the word actually comes. Because even the Kaka Kata, if you take, there is so much of things we are yet to learn in that story. We've just learned the overall meaning of the story. But if you go into the grammar part and all that, every word can go into further, you know, identifying what is the root word, what is the derivative from there, so on and so forth. It's one huge thing. Okay. So I'm just going to finish with this Prahelika for today.
So Praveena, one question.
Yeah.
On the sheets you showed us, on the top left, it said Vyavaharik Shabdaha. Does that mean business words?
Vyavaharika is regular usage words. Vyavaharika, we transact these words. We use these
life. I mean, what you use in your normal course of life. Normal usage.
Day-to-day life.
That's why we had Vyavaharika as animals, Vyavaharika as stationery. Yeah. What do you use in conversation?
So in this, we are focusing on the Lekana Samagri. So
writing
instruments of daily usage. So
Lekan Phalakam is an exam board.
Yeah, any board is Phalakam.
Lekana Phalakam is a writing board.
Yeah.
It should be called a writing board. Exam would be Pariksha or something, right?
So
this is a writing board. It's a pad. It's writing a pad. So means
we don't directly translate, you know.
Palakam is a board.
In fact, for the blackboard, we call it as Krishna Palakam. whiteboard we call it as the Shweta Palakam. So
but this is so beautiful. Patra Bharaha.
Yeah.
Patra Bharaha. Paperweight.
Yeah, paperweight. So Patra Bharaha, what will the Shabda be?
Patra Bharaha Akaranta Pullingaha.
So that's how you start thinking about it. The moment you see a word, now you should start identifying.
No, exactly. We should not actually go get confused by this English or Tamil agrinai and uyarthinai or that, you know, living thing and
shabdas, not by the meaning
living
of the
thing
word.
And non-living thing. We should not associate living thing and non-living thing. We should just go by the words.
The beauty of Sanskritam is, for every word, what happens is, they will have so many different words which can have different genders. So the beauty of it comes there. For the same word, for example, for a friend, I have a sakha, which could be feminine gender. Mitram is a masculine gender. Snehitaha is like a masculine gender. Mitram is a napumsakalinga. So you can have the same meaning, but the word can have different genders.
Maitri is strilingam?
No, Maitri is one of the derived forms of this. Mitram is napumsakalingam.
So if I have a lady friend, how will you call her?
Snehita.
Sakhi. Sakha sakhi.
But lady friend can also be addressed as Mitram. You can call that in neuter gender also. We will be doing some things like that. Like the Kaka was called in masculine gender in our story. Your lady friend can be called with Napumsakalinga usage also.
Okay, got it.
It's all by the Shabdas, not by the meaning. That's what we
Pravina Guru.
Yes.
I just saw that rubber stamp was called Mridu Mudra and rubber band was called Rubber Bandha. How does it become Mridu Mudra?
Mridu is soft, Mudra is a symbol. So a rubber stamp, though we say it's rubber stamp, it's a printing, a sign, a symbol, right? Seal,
yeah.
It's a seal.
So no, I just wanted to know.
Just the soft pad translation that they have
seal.
Done.
Mudra is the seal.
Sujata Bhagini, these are not like, hard and fast things. It's more to show that, we can add two words to create our own words.
Okay.
So, you could possibly call rubber band also in a very different way because it is also mridu only. So, mridu bandaha also is possible for that. Here, okay. I think it's a soft pad or a soft stamping pad. They've called it mridu bandaha. That's all.
Okay.
We can create our words with all these things. That's it.
Kartari.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So, let's finish with this one. Vishnoho pa vallabha devi. So Vishnoho, this is Ukaranta, we've not done. Ka Vallabha. Vallabha would be what?
Vallabha.
Vishnu.
Akaranta. Akaranta pulling. Akaranta Srilinga.
Vallabha. Akaranta Srilinga. Vishnu is Ukaranta. We've not done with Ukaranta. So Vallabha, immediately they are using Ka. If you can see, that's what we learned in this particular place. So, sa means ka, right? So, sa, ka, taha, kaha, we learned that concept, right? So, we are applying that in this prahelika that we are seeing. Vishnoho, ka vallabha, the answer has to be sa vallabha. Sa Vishnoho vallabha, ka vallabha, devi. So, who is the vallabha devi of Vishnu? Loka Hrithaya Charini, who handles all the three worlds. Varna Vadyantimau Dattva Saha Shabdaha Tulyavachakaha. Tulyavachakaha. Tulya means equivalent. Tulyavachakaha means what is the equivalent Shabda? Kaha Shabdaha Tulyavachakaha. Again, Kaha is used for Shabdaha. So, we saw that, Ramaha, Kaha Ramaha, Saha Ramaha, so Ekavachana Rupam. Kaha Shabdaha. So, Kaha Shabdaha Tulya Vachakaha. What is the Shabda which is equivalent? Of what? Varna, Tyaktva. So, they are saying that we have to remove off Varnau Adyantimau Tyaktva. Adi Antam of that particular word, if you remove, then what you get is the equivalent of the name of Vishnoho Vallabha. So who is the Vallabha of Vishnu and who handles the three word, that Devi's name will be got if you remove the first and the last alphabet of this word, which means equivalent. So what is that word? It's the Prahelika. Okay. So the answer to that
Vadyantima.
Vadyantima. The first and the last alphabet should be removed.
Adyan.
Okay. Then you get the Tulya Vachakaha. So what do they say here? Vishnoho Vallabha Loka Tritaya Charini Devi. She is Ma. So she is Ma, Mahalakshmi. So Ma is Lakshmihi. So here the Adi Aksharam is Sa, middle Aksharam is Ma, Antima Aksharam is Na. Samanam means Tulyam. So the equivalent, the word for the equivalent is Tulyam. So Tulyam means Samanam. So if you remove the first alphabet Sa and the final alphabet Na, then what you get is Ma, which means Mahalakshmi. So the very Aksharam of Ma is Mahalakshmi. That's what they are communicating.
Ma is Mahalakshmi.
Prahedi. Okay. So got this?
Varna Vadyanti Dattva Kaha Shabdaha Tulya Vachakaha Ma Sa.
Okay. So you all got this, right?
Vishnoho Ka Vallabha Devi.
Okay. So tomorrow we will try to continue with the fifth chapter.
I was Praveena, sorry. Can you just repeat the how you got the answer of that Prahelika only once, please?
No, it gives you two reasons. It says who is Vishnu's Vallabha and who handles all the three worlds.
Okay, that is Ma.
That is the first question. And then it says the Arambam Antima Aksharam. If you remove that Aksharam, which will actually give the meaning of Tulyam or equivalent.
No, can you break that second line? Second line and all. Varna Vadyantimau. That line, can you break it up and explain? First word, first line, I got it. Vishnu Ka Vallabha Devi Loka Tritaya Charini, I got.
Varnau Adhyantimau Tattva.
What is that? Varnau
Adhyantimau. Adi Antama. Adhyantimau.
Adhya is Adi Anta.
Adi Anta. Imau dattva, etad dvayam, if you just remove, kaha shabdaha tulya vachakaha, which by which shabda is tulya actually explained.
Okay.
So, we will see, if possible, we will try to complete the second chapter, but now because you all are not rushing for the exam, I'm okay. So we can even take a little more time, but try to practice the Prathama Vibhakti because we will be going on to the Dvitiya Vibhakti tomorrow.
Right. Oh, have a class.
Thanks. Any questions on whatever we did today?
And then I have
also. Nothing as of now, Praveena, and I am exiting because it's a working day. I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, thank you. Sarvesham Dhanyavadaha.
Dhanyavad. But class, okay, the class, okay, Sanskrit order class, 8:32.
Whose voice is that?
It is Kala Bhagini.
Very sorry.
Okay. So I think we will wrap up for today with this. And tomorrow we will go on to the same thing, but Dvitiya Vibhakti details we will see tomorrow. We will also complete that song tomorrow, which we started today. Priya Siddhi Sattve Bhavati. Sorry?
Voice can't
tell you. Okay. Astu, Dhanyavad.
Guru, tomorrow can you again repeat this Prahelika once again?
Okay, sure.
Because there was a lot of disturbance, so okay, one or two words.
Sure.
Yeah, the second part of it, even I did not understand.
Yes, Guru. So the whole thing in short, if you can just
start with that tomorrow.
Yeah, because Raji was talking and it was very difficult to understand.
Yes, yes.
Do you want me to do it now or tomorrow?
We'll do it tomorrow, Guru.
We'll do it tomorrow. Okay. Dhanyavada.
Thank you.
Okay, Dhanyavada. Shwaha Milama.
Shwaha Milama.